Sun's up. Honey, wake up. Greet the day. Shelby, honey, you gotta wake up. That's it. That's it. I've had it.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you enjoyed that intro. That was so much fun to make. I tried to use inspiration from some of my favorite early 2000s movies, which are Legally Blonde, Freaky Friday, the Lizzie McGuire movie, even Bring It On. So I hope you caught that. But today we're going to be doing early 2000s makeover. So I was born in 1996, so when 2000 hit, I was 4. And I do have a lot of memories of the early 2000s, but mine are really more so about like the TV shows I watched and the food and the snacks I was eating. So I didn't necessarily get to do all these trends like when it came to makeup and clothing just because I was so little. But today I'm gonna live out my fantasy of being the coolest early 2000s girl. I remember seeing girls on movies and the music videos and like even people that were friends with my brother because he was 17, I think, whenever I was 4. So he was in high school during the early 2000s, so I got to see like all these things through him, kind of. You know, there's Britney Spears, NSYNC, all the things. So I'm gonna do my best to recreate that for you guys, and I hope you enjoy. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe. It would mean a whole lot to me. So let's get started. Okay, so I'm gonna do my hair after I do my makeup, but let's start with foundation. So I feel like in the early 2000s there wasn't like all this heavy contouring and like cuts and the making jawlines and cheekbones and all that stuff. There was pretty much like basic foundation from what I've seen. Let me look at Pinterest just to see, like, get some inspiration. Okay, so here's a picture of Cameron Diaz. I actually love this look. It's like the simple eyeshadow, kind of a purple color, and then she has the blush. It doesn't look like she has heavy contour or anything like that. Maybe some bronzer on the forehead and then like a brown colored lip. I think that's definitely something that we could try. Okay, so then also we have Britney Spears, the queen herself. It looks like she has some purplish eyeshadow too, and you gotta have the shimmer, of course. Bronzer on the face, but like just to make it look like she has color. I don't know, let's see what we can do. I also really like this too. Again, purple shimmery eyeshadow, some nice cute blush, and then like basic foundation from what it looks like, the eyeliner on the bottom. Yeah, let's try to recreate something like these pictures. All right, so for my foundation, I'm not a makeup artist, by the way. If you think you're gonna actually like learn tips from me, don't get your hopes up. I use a Lancome foundation in shade 100. So we're gonna put that on my beauty blender. And then also I mix in this Bye Bye foundation by It Cosmetics. Just because I feel like the other one is a little too pale for me, but this one's also too dark for me. So when I mix them together, it seems to be the right shade. So, I don't know. So I do like to use a beauty blender first just to spread it out on the face, and then I go with a foundation brush just to kind of smooth it out, because I feel like, for me personally, it gives me a smoother look with my foundation. Bring it down to the neck, always. I don't know if you can even tell a difference on the camera from here to here, but I can in person. I turned off my other makeup mirror because I think it was too bright. So let's do the same thing on the other side of my face. Okay, so now I got the foundation on. I'm gonna put just a little bit of concealer under my eyes just because my eyes do look a little dark and I look kind of tired, so I use the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Eraser. I feel like that's a pretty generic one and I've never had a problem with it. Do I look more awake now? I hope so. Alright, so for the bronzer I'm going to use the typical Anastasia contour palette. I've had this thing for years, so let's take Let's take my big fluffy brush. I'm just gonna put it in the middle color. It's almost gone. I'm gonna do that like a 3 because that's honestly how my sister-in-law taught me to do it whenever I was probably 11 years old. And I've heard that technique in the early 2000s also. So 1, 2, 3. Just to add some sun-kissed look to your face. Let's do it on this side. And then going off of this picture again, it looks like she has, you know, a good amount of bronzer on her forehead, so I'm just gonna put a little more on my forehead. Now, let's move to blush. I'm gonna use my Bare Minerals blush. It's in the shade Vintage Peach. So, tap this. It does seem like they focus more on the apples of the cheek for blush, so I'm just gonna put it there. Do I look sun-kissed? Let's see. And now for the fun part, eyeshadow. I'm getting a very purple vibe for this, and I just remember that's the one color eyeshadow I had when I was young. It was like a bright purple, looked like this, kind of, right here. The great thing about the early 2000s also is it looks like they just put eyeshadow on their whole lid instead of trying to do like these cut creases all over the place, which works great for me because I have hooded eyes, so even if I were to be very intricate with my eyeshadow, you wouldn't see it. I'm scared, I don't want to pick the wrong color. So this eyeshadow palette is from Amazon. It has worked fine for me. I think it's Fantasy palette from what it looks like. But yeah, I'm thinking of going in with this purple color. I think that's right, or should I do this? I think I'm gonna do this and then we'll see what happens. So some of the things that I remember from the early 2000s are the shows that I used to watch all the time. And I was a hardcore Lizzie McGuire fan. Like, just don't pay attention to my eyeshadow. Just trust the process. But yeah, I watched Lizzie McGuire every day on Disney Channel when it came out. I went to the Hilary Duff concert. I had Lizzie McGuire decals stuck on my door. I put, I had a Lizzie McGuire suitcase, a Lizzie McGuire jacket that I wore all the time. She was my everything. And then when the Lizzie McGuire movie came out, ugh, I loved it. I saw it in theaters with my parents and then I bought it on DVD and I still have it to this day. Yeah, I think this is the vibe I'm going for. I kind of like it. I kind of feel like Gwen Stefani right now, just a little bit. Another thing was like the snacks that you had in the early 2000s. Does anyone remember Go-Gurt? I had so many of those in my house. And then the Trix yogurt. Oh, that was so good. I feel like the early 2000s food and snacks were so terrible for you. And like, I don't know, the stuff we grew up on just feels like it was very unhealthy every time I think about it. I also really liked those Kool-Aid Burst or Kool-Aid Jammers. What were they called? They're like in the plastic bottle and you twist the top off. I'll put a picture on the screen, but I loved those so much. Every time I think of the early 2000s, I honestly just think of the color purple, which is probably why I'm doing a purple eyeshadow, but my bedroom was fully purple. I had purple curtains, a purple canopy over my bed. The early 2000s, the color for it was purple, I'm convinced. Now I'm gonna go with this brighter shade of purple right here and just add it and see how it looks. I don't know. I remember my brother had a poster of Britney Spears in his room, but my parents didn't allow stuff like that because we grew up like going to church and all that stuff, but he hid it under his bed and I remember finding it and I was like, oh my God, it was so scandalous to me. She had this green outfit on. She looked so cool, but yeah, he didn't get to hang that up. I also had, you know, the furniture that was the blow up furniture. I had a purple blow up chair in my room and I put Powerpuff Girl stickers all over it because I wanted a Powerpuff Girl chair, but they didn't have that, so I made my own. I had the beads that you hang in your window. Loved those, I was obsessed. And then I remember my mom would always do the butterfly hair clips in my hair, which we have those coming, don't worry. I had the little space buns all the time, which I think I'm gonna do that today because it's such a throwback for me, but I called them Arthur ears because you remember the show Arthur? I watched that every single morning and it just reminded me of his ears, so. Arthur ears, space buns. You guys remember the Scooby-Doo fruit snacks? Ugh, the blue ones, the best ones, so good. Gushers were a big thing. We can't forget the shimmer also, so I'm gonna just use this little white shimmery color right here. Put it under the brow bone and maybe add it on my lid as well. But oh yeah, the snacks were everything. The little, ooh, do you remember those ice creams that were, they're called push pops, and it's it had a little stick at the bottom and it was like a cylinder at the top and you just push it and it comes up and you just eat it. Me and my boyfriend were talking the other day about how they just don't make, or like the same, the movies in the early 2000s were top tier, okay? And they don't know how to make movies like that anymore. They try to make the romantic comedies and it's just the vibe is not there. And I don't know what it is. I don't know what it's missing. In the early 2000s, you had the music, you had the cinematography just seemed different. It felt like every movie was either filmed in New York or San Francisco, I don't know. A Cinderella Story, that was the best movie in the world to me. I had that on DVD and I played it, I think, daily. But then again, Hilary Duff was like my idol, so. I'm gonna definitely add shimmer to my lid also. I just need more. I'm looking at the picture and I think this is good enough. I'm gonna take this brush again and use some light brown and just go right here with it. Get that smudged kind of look. Also, a really big thing in the early 2000s was belly button piercings. I was so enamored with those. My mom made it very clear that she never wanted me to have one. So I got one when I was like 20. And I only had it for a week, but at least I tried it. Okay, we did the eyeshadow on the bottom on the waterline. Now I'm gonna try and do my lashes, and I don't feel like there was a lot of false lashes going on back then. And if they were, they were very subtle, but I'm not gonna add them. Okay, so for mascara, I use the L'Oreal Voluminous one that a lot of other people use, and then I also go over that with the L'Oreal Telescopic Mascara. You can't tell me L'Oreal doesn't have the best mascara when it comes to drugstore mascaras, so. Mascara is a lifesaver. I look like a whole new person when I put mascara on. Okay, I've done the top mascara. It looks like she has some on the bottom lashes, but first I wanna do eyeliner. So, she definitely has black eyeliner on, but do you remember that they had colorful eyeliner back then where it was like actually a trend to do it? I have this bright blue eyeliner that I took from my grandma one time, and I think I should put it on the bottom. I think we should do it. Let's just do it. ASMR. It looks kind of just like black eyeliner, but if you look up close, it's like, oh yeah, blue eyeliner on. Okay, we have the bottom eyeliner on, and now I'm gonna do bottom mascara. Okay, so now for lips, hers is like obviously a tan brown, like lip gloss, lipstick combination, maybe. I don't have lipstick, and I also don't have any of that color lip gloss. But I do have a brown lip liner pencil. I know so many people used to do this in the early 2000s, like the dark lip liner with the lighter in the middle. So I'm gonna try and see what I can come up with, but let's do the brown lip liner and just go from there. Bear with me, please. I look like I have a mustache. You know what I just remembered? Oh, do you remember that store, Libby Lou? And it was always in the mall and you can go in and get like a makeover and your hair done, and they would spray glitter in your hair, and then you could like make your own bath soap, or you can make your own candy, and they had decorations for your room, and it was all like pink and purple and sparkles. It was the coolest place ever. I wanted to go there every single time I went to the mall. I think I got my hair done there twice, and it was just the coolest experience. It was a whole moment. Ugh, what a great place. I'm not the best at lip liner, but I mean, I guess it looks okay. Okay, I have this contour stick. Is this gonna be crazy? I don't know, let's just try it. Is that working? Wait, is this working? Oh my god, okay. I'm gonna clean up the lip liner just because it looks a little crazy, but this is just the NYX little contour stick, and I think it worked pretty well. right, you know what, guys? I think the makeup is done. Now, we can move on to hair. Okay, so now we're gonna do the hair. And like I was saying before, I'm just gonna do the little twisty space buns up here. And I'm thinking I'm gonna do the zigzag middle part. Ugh, I remember asking my mom to do that on my hair. Okay, yes, this is what I want. Again, we have Britney Spears, we have the space buns. I don't know if I can get them to be that like messy, but I'm gonna do the little front pieces like this also, and then the little zigzaggy part, and I think that's gonna look cute. Let's start with the part, obviously. Okay, I'm nervous. Okay, I don't know if you can tell, but here's the zigzag. I have no idea what the back of my hair is gonna look like, but if you can't see it, it doesn't matter, right? Let's get a little front piece going on like that. Whatever, okay, we're gonna do this and then do this one. My mom would do my hair all the time. My mom went to beauty school though, so she actually knew what she was doing. Okay, I think this is working. Wait, let me not speak too soon. That's cute. And it's okay if hairs stick out like that because in the picture she looked like she had some little hairs coming out of her space buns. That's cute. Stuff I was not supposed to be watching as a kid. Flava of Love. That show, I would sit in my parents' room and I would like say this is my remote. I would have my finger on the button that would go to the previous channel before, which was probably Disney, but I'd be watching Flava of Love in my parents' room with the remote like this, and as soon as I heard anything, I would hit the button and then it would look like I'm watching Disney Channel, which is hilarious. But that show was so entertaining. And also Girls Next Door, definitely should not have been watching that either, but it looks cute. I think I did a good job. Good job, me. And the pictures, theirs were like very straight and stiff. Yeah, like this. Okay. I think it looks so cute, but we're not done yet. Because, da-da-da, the best part. I got butterfly hair clips, you guys. Let me take them out of the package. They're so cute. I had so many of these. What I used to do when what my mom used to do, she would take the butterfly hair clips and clip them around my space buns. So I'm gonna try and do that and I hope it looks as good as it used to. Oh, it's so cute. Oh my God, I kinda wanna move this one. That's adorable. Oh my goodness, I love it. Okay, so this is the look for the hair and the makeup. Now we gotta move on to clothes, you guys. My hair is so cute, I love it. Okay, so I have my outfit picked out. I'm gonna show you what it is and then I'm gonna put it on and reveal the final look, but let me go get my clothes. Okay, so for my shirt, I have this cute crop top. It has a little pattern on it. And to me, that just felt very early 2000s, I don't know, but it's cropped. I have cargo pants, but not only cargo pants, low-rise cargo pants, because you already know. The early 2000s, the waistline on everyone's pants was literally like everyone had nothing. It was crazy. Everything was so low-rise, so I have my low-rise cargo pants. And I have my little sunglasses. These are actually my clothes, so I didn't buy these for the video, but let me show you what I did buy. I got myself some of these sandals. You're lying if you say you didn't have something like this. And honestly, in the early 2000s, like the wedge part was a lot thicker. I couldn't find any that was like thicker than this. Yeah, I had some purple sandals like this. I had some orange. A lot of people had the Steve Madden, the black ones with like the one strap across the front. Don't even get me started, but yeah. I'm gonna put this on and then we're gonna show you the look. Okay, you guys, are you ready to see? This is the look. You got the low-rise pants, the cargo pants, and the shoes. So cute. But the one thing that we are missing, you guys. So you know how the tattoo trend, tramp stamp, was very popular in the early 2000s, which is a lower back tattoo? You guys, I went on Amazon and bought tattoos to put on my lower back just to finish off the look. So I'm thinking, okay, yeah, I'm thinking I want to do this one, like the little butterfly. So I'm gonna cut this out and we're gonna put a tramp stamp on my lower back. Okay, so I cut out the tattoo. Even these tattoos remind me of the early 2000s because I would have these all over the place, but we're gonna put this on. Let me see. Okay, I have no clue if this is gonna be straight. It might look crazy. Well, you know, it's gonna look goofy anyway, but still. Okay, have a wet rag and let's just, oh, that's cold. Let's try and peel it off and see. Oh, you guys, this kind of looks real. Wait, look.
What?
But here's the look, you guys, look. The hair, the makeup, really bad lighting right now, but the outfit. And then the little tattoo. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I really enjoyed making it. If you want to let me know some of your favorite things about the early 2000s, please comment down below. I would love to see them. And if you like this video and you want to see more videos of mine, go ahead, subscribe to my channel if you already haven't, and please give this video a like. Thanks so much for watching, you guys. Bye.